This video is sponsored by Simply Safe. Right now, they're having the best sale of the year, but more on that later. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Outdoor Chef Life. I'm Taku, and today we're fishing in San Diego. And the initial plan was to go down to the Mexican waters and fish for yellowfin tuna, but we had some motor issues, so we had to switch up. And we're gonna stick to the local San Diego waters, and we're gonna fish for yellowtail. We're on Kylie and Adam's boat. They're kind enough to invite us on. They're subscribers of mine, and we also have Ensei today. Ensei, my sensei, you know him from my kayak videos. And we also have Jocelyn on the camera, of course. And yeah, we have a bunch of live bait. We're trolling some SP minnows and some divers. We'll see if we can get anything on the troll. If not, we'll try some fly lining too. And yeah, we'll see what happens, guys. Let's get it.
Fish on, go.
Fish
get
on.
It, get it.
Nice. Right on cue, huh? Right on cue, baby.
Yellowtail?
I think it's a bonito.
He's on that.
Oh, he's running.
Nice one. There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Woohoo. And that's how we started. Yeah. Heck yeah. That's a nice one. That's a nice one. There we go.
But then it's really hard to
hit. Hey, that's a good start.
You can put it on my chair.
Thank you. Right on cue. All right, since we just got that bonito, we're going to put a live sardine on here now. Let's see. Where's the lucky bait? Who's a lucky bait here? All right, so I'm just gonna hook him through the nose right there. You got live bait. And we're just gonna let him swim. Oh, Kylie's got a fish. Got a fish on. That was pretty cool, huh? I sent the drone up and Kylie hooked up on a nice bonito. Look who we run into, it's Die Hard Fishing.
How was the bonito? Was it good at least?
Yeah, it was a nice one. It's a nice bonito.
Nice.
Awesome.
Alright, man.
You.
Yeah, good luck.
Get him, man. I marked some in here too.
And we're back to trolling. There's way too many sea lions and they keep taking the bait. So we're just trolling four lines right now, hoping we can get some yellowtail bites. But let me tell you guys about our sponsor for today. Simply Safe is a home security system that you just order online. Really easy to set up. You just stick the sensors in the corners of the rooms, just like I did. If you're a viewer of the channel, you know that Jocelyn and I just moved to a new place. Before this place, we were living with roommates. Somebody was always home, so I wasn't too worried about, you know, people breaking in. But now that we live alone, we got our own place, and the home that we live in is pretty old. Now that I have Simply Safe, I can safely and confidently travel, leave the house for 3 days or even weeks at a time without having to worry about somebody breaking in. They got sensors to cover every window, every door, water sensor, freezer sensor, things like that. Things I don't need a freezer sensor because I'm in California. We don't have that problem. But they got it. If you need it, they got it. And it's all controlled from a nice home base.
Simply Safe on. Home.
Because there's an increase in break-ins during the holidays, Simply Safe is hooking you up with the best deal of the year with 30% off, plus this HD camera that you can check on your phone from anywhere around the world. So visit simplysafe.com/outdoorcheflife for 30% off. So thank you to Simply Safe for sponsoring today's video. Now let's catch some more fish.
Me.
Yeah, look at him, look at him. Funny. All right, I'm gonna grate this daikon right into this pot.
Heck yeah.
Oh, look at them, three of them.
Aww. They heard you're making sushi.
They're you here. Heard that I was making sushi? Oh my god, this grater doesn't work very well. Alright, instead of grating it, we're just going to chop up the daikon like this. Alright. This is momiji right here. It's just like a chili paste, basically. Alright, we're going to mix this in with the daikon. Preferably with the, when you grate the daikon, you can squeeze out all the moisture and then mix it in. That's how you normally do it. Alright, we'll mix this up. Just like that, and we basically have chili daikon. Normally we call it momiji oroshi, but and then I'm going to just add ponzu to that. Makes a delicious sauce. Spicy ponzu. Looks much better when you grate the daikon. And I'm using Kylie's beautiful knife here. Really nice, beautiful looking knife. Piece there and the other piece. And there we go. Got two fillets, nice and clean carcass. Yeah, so with bonito is like one of those fish that you want to eat almost right away because if you eat it, so we caught this a few hours ago, right? And now is the time to eat it because the meat is still nice and firm. If you wait a day, even just one day, 2 days, the meat will start breaking apart. It'll start getting mushy and the quality of the flesh would be a lot less. He's been waiting patiently. Got some sesame oil here.
Ooh,
a little too much there. Bunch of sesame oil on all this fish here. That's good. Now I have my torch. I don't have anything else. My cutting board isn't the most ideal thing to put torch on, but underside as well. figure some cucumbers would be good in here. With the ponzu. With the ponzu is really good.
Just roll them up.
And the way I was gonna do it, I sliced these on a mandolin. Like this. He's like
Broccoli
frowning.
Neck. He looks really unimpressed.
Just like that. I'm just gonna put it all over. And you can go pretty heavy on this too. So I'm gonna just go all over the cucumber as well. A little lemon zest. Let's get a little sea salt in here.
Danish
sea salt from Life. Oh, this is my special right here. This is, look at that. Fermented wasabi hot sauce with Thai chilies, homegrown. So this is actually, I made from actual fresh wasabi, and I fermented that because, oh, shout out to Half Moon Bay Wasabi, by the way, because they had too much wasabi, they harvested too much, so they were like, oh, you want some? So they sent me 3 pounds of fresh wasabi, which is worth probably close to $300. So I didn't know what to do with that much wasabi, so I decided to ferment it and then turn it into hot sauce. And it's actually pretty good. It was a little experiment, so we're gonna try that on here too. I'm gonna get pretty by putting some edible flowers on there. Alright guys, it's fresh bonito sashimi with spicy ponzu, little fermented wasabi hot sauce, some cucumbers, and some Danish sea salt to top it off. Oh, and some edible flowers.
Looks incredible.
That's
look
amazing.
Thank you.
This is the prettiest thing I've ever seen.
Thank you. Here, you guys can share this one.
Okay.
Right. I'll make one for me and Jocelyn, and then I'll make one for Ensei. Okay.
Damn, whipped it up. 15 minutes. Let's go.
It was bomb, bro. Thanks, man.
Yeah,
thanks for
taking
us out. Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Our pleasure.
Yeah, we loved pleasure.
So this one's for the seal, right?
Yeah. Yep,
give it
to the seal. Go ahead.
All right. Jump.
Should we take like a piece of cucumber, a piece of fish, or just?
No, just go for it.
Just dive in. Right. Yeah. Thanks for working.
Thank
us
you
up.
So much. Wow.
Might be a little spicy.
It's like crunchy and spicy.
That citrus on there is.
Oh my gosh. Amazing.
Thank you.
That's awesome. So good.
Amazing.
That wasabi hot sauce is pretty money.
Can you taste it on there?
Yeah.
I just went just for the sauce,
it's
and you get
so
like
good.
You get the wasabi taste, but it's pretty mild.
Yeah, I got my beer.
Got your beer? All right, Jocelyn has a beer.
Oh.
And I forgot to give Ensei his.
Oh, they're just gonna give it to the seal.
I just left
like, oh,
it over
the
there.
Seal.
There you go. Cheers, guys. Right,
cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Thank you. Thank you for taking us.
So
it's our pleasure.
Amazing.
Thank you
Thanks
so
for
much.
All this
come
stuff
on,
Ensei.
Ensei, come on.
Cheers.
Where's your beer, dude?
I don't have
There's
one.
A bunch of beers where you're standing underneath.
Ensei's already messed up.
Thank you so much.
Oh, good beer. Is it good?
Oh, bro. Thank you.
Okay.
Gives me the fresh bonito.
Yeah. Fresh bonito is really good. And then daikon flavor actually comes out a lot. The chopped daikon, instead of grated, actually works. It works pretty well.
Mm. Yeah, that's
the wasabi.
That crunchiness is nice.
My wasabi hot sauce.
Yeah, that hot sauce. You've got to start selling that stuff.
Yeah, market it.
That, there's so probably. Good. There's at least $100 worth of fresh wasabi in there, so it's not going to be easy to sell.
$200 a bottle? Yeah,
$200
you're all
per
set.
Bottle.
You got your first customers right here.
Market is the most expensive hot sauce in the world.
Yeah. I can cut more fish.
Oh my gosh.
That's awesome. Yeah. Really? How much of that did you drink?
Oh man, thank you.
You want more of the hot sauce?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
Just a little bit, though.
It's only like $20 worth. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, dang.
Hurry up, get a container. We need to save it. Those guys on the radio are going to be sorry they made fun of Bonito.
Yeah, people who make fun of Bonito.
I feel like they just don't get it.
They just don't get it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I thought I was going to definitely like your yellowtail recipe better.
Yeah.
But kind of like this more.
Is it this, the Bonito is better than the yellowtail one?
Maybe.
Maybe.
I have to have the same recipe side by side with both.
All right, guys, I think that's going to wrap it up. Thanks to Simply Safe for sponsoring this video once again. And thank you guys for taking us out.
It's our pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for watching. And if you like the video, hit that thumbs up, subscribe. See you guys next time. Peace. Woo. You want more?
Yeah. It's really like so amazing.
Yeah, yeah, man.
That wasabi. It's just like I've never had anything.